That's just the kind of courage I'm looking for. Modest as well as brave. Most admirable. I can see why the Skoll think highly of you. Yes, I think you're just the adventurous sort I need. I have a job offer for you. As a scholar of history, I've always found Solstheim to be most intriguing. I've made many forays into the ancient ruins that cover the island. I've come to know those ruins so well, I could draw you a map from memory. That's why I noticed the new passage the moment I laid eyes on it. An old tomb, I think. It must have been opened by an earthquake that accompanied one of the Red Mountain's eruptions. I'd love to have a closer look. But those old ruins can be dangerous, and I'm no adventurer. I'll pay you to watch my back down there. I'll be heading back there soon. If you're interested, meet me at the ruins, and we'll see what we can find. Now I'm off to pack for the expedition.
You risked your life to save Baldur. Your name will be honored in our village. Until next time.
Set of stairs. Remarkable, isn't it? This tomb has been hidden for, well, who knows how long? Many centuries. There are some seals. I've had a look around, and the only interesting thing I've found is this inscription here. The switch below it.
Oh, wow. This is gorgeous.
Now, I'm not sure if you can read the dragon language, but this seems to be a riddle of some sort. A sacrifice will bring you closer to that which you seek. I wonder what it means. Mind your step. There seem to be some corpses strewn about on the floor here. I wonder if this fire pit has anything to do with the riddle. You go ahead and see what you can figure out. I'll look around and see if I can find anything of use.
I'll have to come back to this place later and take detailed notes.
Who knows what dangers await us in this place? Three pillars. Other than that plaque, there doesn't seem to be anything else worthy of note. Let's see what the inscription says. All men must die, often by their own means. Sounds rather grim if you ask me. The inscription must be a reference to pillars. Three pillars surrounding a central one. Perhaps they're connected somehow. They also have glowing stones of some kind at the top. They look vaguely similar to drawings I've seen of objects called impact stones. Well, see what you can figure out. I'm going to inspect these pillars further to see if I've missed something. Walking in these chambers is like walking in the past. Perhaps a different kind of attack will yield better results.
I was always taught to avoid these types of ruins. I think I see why now.
Let's see what mysteries await us in the next room.
Yeah!
Who knows what games await in this place? Let's have a closer look at these rooms. The writing describes a guardian who defeated someone named Mirak. In fact, if I'm reading this correctly, it says that Mirak was a traitor. Most interesting. There's probably an exit through one of these sarcophagi. Let's get moving. I was afraid the earthquakes might have done serious damage here, but the tomb seems to be in fine condition. I expect there's another riddle in here, along with a puzzle. Continue along the path. Don't tread where you've been. Interesting. I'm pretty sure about two things. One, the riddle is most likely referring to these flat square stones. And two, I'm not going anywhere near them. Five more to go. Now let's just hope something good happens when we hit the last one. And splendid! The gates have opened. Find out what's written. This writing refers to a guardian who inspired both men and dragons. I wonder if the guardian was himself a man or a dragon. Looks like a secret message in the along the wall. You lead the way. I would love to hear the stories they could tell. That's it. All right. Let's see what we have next. Here's another riddle. Stay your course. To idle is to die. Well, at least it's straightforward. There appears to be a switch of some kind here. I'll just stand over here while you flip that switch. By the nine, I've never seen anything like this. Quite a drop.
Is there something moving down there?
Must be hundreds of years of history etched in these walls. Too bad they seem too damaged to read. Here's another of those dragon language inscriptions. And his reward was an honorable death. Quite fascinating. How amazing! A real dragon priest. In all my years as a historian, I never thought I'd see anything like that. I suppose that was Valok. He must have had this entire place built for him so that he could maintain his vigil, even beyond death. Indeed. I knew that the dragon priests were thought to have been powerful men of great will, but I had no idea. Well, I suppose I've seen everything I came for, and you kept up your end of the bargain. I promised payment, and here it is. Now I think I'll spend some more time studying this word war. What a book this will make!